West Virginia is coal country, and it has been for generations. But coal production has been on a steady decline here since the early 1990s. And in the last 6 years, it's taken a complete nosedive. That has led to a loss of jobs and, for many, a loss of hope. Enter Donald Trump.
And for those miners, get ready because you're going to be working your asses off, all right? Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Well, here we are. We are in the heart of coal country, also the heart of the collapse of coal. President Trump made a lot of promises to the coal miners. He said he's going to give them a big bright tomorrow. We're here in Mingo County, West Virginia, to see what does that mean to the folks who live here. First of all, I'm just incredibly happy to be here.
I meet up with a group that definitely knows coal. Terry Steele retired after mining for 26 years. Bo Copley has been laid off since 2015. He's sort of a coal mining celebrity for this exchange with Hillary Clinton during the campaign.
I just want to know how you can say you're going to put a lot of coal miners out of jobs and then come in here and tell us how you're going to be our friend.
And Alan Lardieri is one of the lucky ones. He's got a job in the mines.
My first question is simply this. What does Trump have to do to deliver, to satisfy folks?
My whole reasoning for voting for Trump was not because of policies, but the presence of Trump. You know, his unconventional nature will cause a political shakeup somewhat. You got a political gene pool that it's entirely inbred. What I mean by that is you have these career politicians, the same individuals that's populated Capitol Hill for so long, they're so disconnected from their base. Mm. Trump being such an outsider will make people start to think and realize, hopefully, like, oh, wait, we could possibly lose our jobs if we don't become more representative.
Now, some people say that the reason coal has been having so many problems is because Obama came in, he overregulated. But looking at the numbers, coal's been declining really since the 90s. Do you feel like it's maybe sometimes overstated the damage that Obama did?
It was on the decline, yes, because there's alternative means for electric power generation, all that stuff. But when you see the drop happen, they yanked the carpet out from under West Virginia. These regulatory agencies were populated by activists, essentially. So now you have people that are the polar opposite of that. And that's where you're going to get a lot of positive action on coal, with a little bit of scaling back of the overregulation.
You know, you got famous because of the challenge you laid out to Hillary Clinton. If Hillary Clinton had a different position on coal mining, would you have voted for her?
No, sir.
Why not?
On the very fact alone of pro-life.
So many pundits have said, if she hadn't offended those coal miners, they would have voted for her. They don't know your heart. They didn't know that there was something underneath that that you also were concerned about.
Everyone always thinks that we're one topic people, you know.
Right. Yeah,
and we're not.
You guys are Christians and very proud of it. As a Christian couple, how can you support a Donald Trump when you know the fear he strikes into the hearts of American Muslim children, American Latino children? How do you round that circle?
Sorry, it hits kind of close to home to her. Some of her family won't speak to me right now because of my support of Donald Trump. And
we have a Muslim American family.
Her sister is married to a Jordanian man. And, you know, they never expressed their fears to us beforehand as far as, but then.
But I wouldn't want anybody to think just because someone's in office that it's not a dictatorship. This is still America. It is still awesome. God put it here for a reason. And it's a country of immigrants. You can't say we're not going to let anybody in, but it has to be done the right, responsible way. But I would like to ask Donald Trump, you know, what are you going to say to those people who are scared? Kids who think, you know, something might happen to them or to their father or mother because of their descent.
Maybe some people love Trump, maybe some people don't love Trump. You've been in this region your whole life. What can Trump do?
When that coal miner is breathing in that coal dust, for you to turn a light switch on and get good cheap energy, there's a price to be paid, and it was paid for here in Central Appalachia. Now, we've reached a point that we need help here. We need help.
My last question is this. Hope is a fragile thing.
Sure is.
and it's hard to get, and when it goes, it's devastating. And you got people here hanging by a thread, and they're putting their faith in Donald Trump. They're down to nothing. Their jobs are gone. Mm-hmm. Their pensions are gone. Their health care isn't there. They're trying to push that opioid away. They see a man who's supposed to be for them. Tell the president what, speak for them to this president.
Mr. President, you're the most unconventional candidate that has ever took this office. A lot of things have happened, a lot of mechanisms in place to put you in there. In your own words, if you do not deliver, you're fired.